evening, everyone, and welcome once again to another episode of Opinion Leaders. And of course, for our televiewers, just to show you that Women's Month is not only for March, but carries on the next month after. And of course, for the rest of the month, we will be talking about women's concerns with, of course, my two very, very special guests from the Philippine Commission on Women. And my guests are the Executive Director, Ms. Emeline L. Versosa, and Chairperson Remedios I. Rican of the Philippine Commission on Women. And we will be talking about women empowerment and gender equality. So very nice to have you both on board.
Yeah. Thank you very much for having us.
Okay, and ma'am, before we start, can you tell us a little bit about the history of PCW and what is the
history? Okay, PCW used to be the National Commission on the Role of Missing Women, and it was established under the presidential decree. That was 1975, when the UN declared the first international conference on women.
Okay.
And our, we call them our pioneers in women's movement, like Senator Sahani, were the ones to ask President Marcos to create the National Commission on the Role of Missing Women.
Okay. So it started off like that.
Yes. But now its new name, after we were able to come out of the Magna Carta of Women, we changed the name. Philippine Commission on Women. I was the executive director after 10 years, no? Because the first 10 years was under Ms. Marcos was the chair at the time. And when EDSA happened, and President Aquino became president, I was appointed executive director in 1986.
Okay.
I wanted to change the name even then, but it was so long.
Yes.
NCRFW, it's so hard to pronounce.
True.
But it will take a lot to change it. Mm-hmm. So I said, I'm not going to waste my time in changing a name.
Mm-hmm.
And it took us up to this time.
Okay.
To have the name changed. Okay. It's basically the same.
Okay.
But sometimes to explain it, no? Because there's another group of women, it's called it's an NGO. The National Council of Women is a non-government agency. PCW is the national machinery, that's the UN partner for that, under the Office of the President.
I see, okay. And right now, for Ma'am Emily naman, how would you say the role of women has, how has it evolved throughout the years?
Oh, since 75.
Since before, and since we started, of course.
Yeah, it's evolved a lot.
Okay.
Before, programs for women were just giving, providing programs for women because we were women, and we're still playing roles as
mothers.
So there was no talk about equality then. Welfare types of programs like cooking and sewing and
like home economics
home
and stuff.
Economics,
okay.
But not, yeah. We connected with our history at the UN. 1975, there were two issues that were brought to Mexico.
Okay.
Equality, development, and peace.
Mm-hmm.
And equality was brought by UN, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, and the US. Third world women at that time did not like the word equality. So they brought the word development. Development will take care of the world.
Mm-hmm.
And the word peace was brought more by Eastern Europe because of the, at the time that it's the height of the Cold War between USA and USSR,
right.
All the armaments nuclear were in Eastern Europe.
So. Oh, right.
And that's why I keep saying that it took 10 years, no? Because they declared a decade, 76 to 85, mid-decade 1980, they met in Copenhagen. The women were not, there was no agreement.
Right.
It took us 10 years, that's why we love to mention Nairobi, the forward-looking strategies of Nairobi, because by that time, 10,000 women came to Nairobi and declared, we see there are three issues, quality development. And then we met again in Beijing in 1995.
And so from then, everything has to fast track.
Beijing, there were 12 areas of concern, from poverty to economy to violence against women, human rights, peace and development, environment. So that's where we declare that all issues are women's issues.
Right.
All issues have an impact differently on women and men.
Yes.
And that's where the advocacy for gender equality is. So today, not the PCW,
okay.
We're under the office of the president, but we're
So this is the official outdoor
IT. It all started in 1966, when the UN said that Nairobi, that's why when I was appointed to the situation, I read a lot of the reports in Nairobi, and Nairobi recommended that it is not just the condition of women, these are all over the world, it is the only ministry that should take care of women's issues, but every government office must look at the programs, the policies, activities, at its impact on women, and it's called mainstreaming. That's the term that
I see.
It's different from treating women as a marginalized sector, or viewing women as participants, especially in economic empowerment. Usually, it's just give women income generating so that they can supplement their husband. But we don't recognize the economic contributions that women have.
Right.
We have a lot of that.
Definitely. As a matter of fact, women now, I would say they've come a long way. If from career, I mean, basic, the basic presentation, as a matter of fact, you see a lot more women are really very much dedicated to their careers and their profession.
At the same time, that's why if you all over the world, look at the women's group, started in the class.
Okay,
so. In 1970, we discovered the form, so we are speaking for the form.
Right.
So, and that's also the reason why even with the Millennium Development Goals and the Beijing class, number one is poverty.
Right. And speaking of, it's a good thing that you brought this up because the Philippines is still, of course, a developing nation and where our population is basically in the lower income bracket. Could you tell our televiewers, what are the main concerns in the problem that the Philippine women face today, especially in the lower income bracket?
There's always this foreigners come to visit. They usually meet a real woman, outspoken women, and they protest throughout the country. You know, if you want to really influence the change, you must be able to reach the women, to support women. And that's why part of our program is our economic empowerment. And basically,
micro.
There are more women in that particular
sector.
And they are very happy with how things are developing along that line. Mm-hmm. But basically, the improvement is from women in development to gender and development. Gender and development means you look at the relationship between men and women and how it can be improved.
Mm-hmm.
So that men also recognize that there are also fathers. It's not just the mothers who takes care of the children.
Right, so it should be more unified, more equal in a sense that, for example, if the mother needs to do something at work, the father should also be able to take that role. And it doesn't matter on kung sino lang ang dapat at that time.
Yeah.
Right.
Now, what we're saying is that before, who takes care of the children?
True, yeah.
The life of the home, or ilaw ng tahanan ng isang pipi, no? If the mother stays home, the one that goes out to work is the man, no?
Right.
But this time, because of economic necessity, women are forced to go to work.
Uh-huh.
And what we found out in 1985, globally, is that this is precisely the greatest injustice in the world. Both men and women work outside the home, but when they go home, everything, the childbirth, time giving, and home maintenance, it's all hers.
Yes.
So we said that there should be some change. And that's also where identifying housework as a shared work. Now, because traditionally that's the job of women.
Right.
So if housework is working, there's no woman.
And there's no
man. Every woman is a working woman. That's
right.
The means of that.
Exactly.
And every issue is, all issues are women's issues.
Okay. So at this point, spearheading from that statement, what do you see as the main problems between men and women? And how is that, and how will we know how to differentiate? Because of course, the problem with the situation in the world is there's so much role playing. And I know we're trying to veer away from that, whether you're a man, whether you're a woman, whether you're a child or whether you're an older person, we should always be able to utilize our talents, whatever age we are and whatever gender we are, right?
That's why, that's why gender is basically changing the culture. For example, when do we start? And we have a research that shows that if you can start from kindergarten, that would be nice, no? I mean, like, but you see, every culture has this looking at men as the head of the family, and the woman is just his strength, and the woman is the inspiration, or the ilaw, or the...
yes.
So, stereotypes that we but try to break the stereotype.
But if you said our vision is joint powering teams, then it would be nice for men to say joint teams. But in the Philippines, as an example of culture, there is this outlook that a man that do housework under the skirt of his wife. It's a cultural thing.
Right? Because I mean, they're your kids too, right? Yeah, it's not like it just happens.
Yeah. I mean, every child that for as long as men do the same as children, their instinct for caring is much more true.
But I think for